Let's now check on the closing numbers at the Philippine Stock Exchange. The local bourse joined the regional downswing on Wednesday. The main index shed 1.7% to retreat to the 6,400 level. Value turnover was at 4 billion pesos. Stock analyst Harold Tan joins us today for some market analysis. He will also weigh in on some of our top business stories today. Welcome to the Business Roadshow again, Harold.
Great to be here again discussing business with you, Stan.
All right, let's talk about that come-from-behind credit rating downgrade for the United States, which is keeping markets keen on the next moves by the Federal Reserve. And how will these affect us, the U.S. economy, and also the global economy in the coming critical months? What is the reason for today's sour performance at the PSE to start with? What do you think?
Of course, the Fed might try to raise rates for about 1 to 2 more times, but they can't overdo it, I believe. They are nearing to reconsider of taking a break or even to cut rates as well. For our local market, the exciting part is when we see inflation coming down near the target of 2 to 4%, and the Fed stops its hawkish decision. We will be all be having a robust market sometime in September or even October, which our initial earliest target for a bull market landfall on the third quarter this year. And hopefully we will eventually come there.
Okay, now Harold, how will the credit rating downgrade even affect investor sentiment for the U.S. market? And in turn, how can emerging markets like ours benefit from it as well?
I think this has just a minimal impact in the U.S. market, as we can see the Dow and the S&P 500 keep on roaring higher. And I believe these things are being disregarded by market sentiment. Even the downgrade news come out as a surprise. Maybe this was already priced in due to their ballooning debt. With the emerging market, I don't think we could benefit from it substantially, since the downgrade will not really cause a huge impact. And an AA plus rating is still an impressive rating for them.
Okay, now Harold, Finance Secretary Benjamin Diokno was on ANC. He said the Philippine economy is poised for greater strides, citing conditions are perfect for this, calling these times, in fact, our moment. And the Philippines is also touted, of course, as one of the best performing economies, along with the lines of India now this year. Are you seeing growth for the country moving forward?
Yes, I agree with our finance secretary with that, and not mentioning that we have the new BSP governor, Eli Remolana, which have the experience working with the Fed. I believe we have a powerhouse economic team that can support the growth of our economy. The current administration is also working hard to close some foreign investment deals, which in turn would improve our standard of living as well, add new job opening, and eventually lower the production cost if everything goes according to the plan.
Okay, Harold, let's talk about the markets now. We've seen the PSE down back to the 6,400 level. Which direction is the market taking now?
Yes, and sadly to say, the momentum is just a short-lived. And we are expecting that, because we are still living in a erratic and choppy market. As you can see, we traded again below the 6,500 level support, and it might continue for the rest of the week. Let's see how the inflation print on Friday boosts our market for the next week.
Yes, we have, of course, inflation coming out on Friday. That's August 4th. We also have corporate earnings coming in, trickling in, a lot of them reporting positive results. Do you think that would help?
Yes, that might help. And of course, on the banking sector, of course, they might be tapering off, I believe, because I think the growth might slightly decrease for the banking sector across the board, and they could have at least maintained it for the rest of this year, because they have all reaped the potential benefit during the recovery period. So for those banking stock investors, I think it's time for them to reconsider taking profit when things don't do well. And for those consumer stocks, I think they will still continue to grow.
Okay, now a lot of analysts we've spoken to on the show are really bullish about earnings, at least for the first half of the year. We're even seeing some positive earnings trickling in from many listed companies today. Metro Bank reported a 34.1% income rise following similar positive revenue jumps from the likes of BDO and BPI. Clearly, the banking sector is leading in this race. Now, Harold, given the seasonality of spending in the Philippines, we're entering the lean months, if you will. Are you still expecting robust earnings in the third quarter of the year, or are these revenue reports likely to taper off now until December, at least?
I think earnings will still be good for this third quarter this year. And of course, like what I have mentioned, not so good for the banks. Maybe the bank will taper off. But of course, for property sector, I can still see that they will still grow because they did not have discovered the full potential of their recovery phase. And in the consumer sector, we can still see those growth. However, of course, those growth are being prevented in the general market. As we can see, all individual issues are coming down. So it's kind of the growth in the business perspective and in the market sentiment are trying to battle out each other. So that's why we don't see any improvement in the market.
And inflation is, of course, still a concern, although it's going down. What's your inflation projection for July 2023 ahead of Friday's announcement? The official number due out, of course. A lot of analysts we've spoken to are bullish. Are we really experiencing some potential inflationary headwinds, though? Because of late, you have fuel prices rising, and there are also some reports of upticks in the prices of some food items. Expected actually during these times, how will this affect the future numbers?
I think we will still be able to hit the BSP target range of 4.1 to 4.9%, but I will have my call on higher spectrum. This is due to the
higher
following
spectrum.
Higher spectrum. This is due to the following of course, the wage increase that has been implemented, and of course, that prevents inflation deceleration. Food prices is all about supply available during and the aftermath of the two typhoons, of which I think we can still manage. Fare increase is what I am fearing because it will have a long-lasting effect.
Yeah.
So the so-called 1 peso rush hour increase, I'm extremely against it because we need to balance things out. It is not enough for public jeep and buses to copy what Grab and other TNBS are doing because these TNBS are considered as luxurious transportation.
Okay.
We are talking about jeep and buses, which is for the mass transportation. I think fuel subsidy is enough for them, for us to have the control over the inflation.
All right. Lastly, Harold, you know what they say about August and the stock market, where investors tend to stay away from the market, ghost month, that is. It has been a long August for you already because you've been out of the market for a long time. Is there any indication that the market, the performance now, is prodding you to return to trading once more? Are you back?
There's a saying that go fish where the fish are. So it is the same thing with the market. If big money is going out of the market during ghost month, then we have nothing to propel the market upward. Mm-hmm. Although based on my observation during ghost month, we only have a 50-50 chance of a retracement during ghost month. Since ghost month is just an added boost to what's going on in the general market. If the market is weak, then ghost month will affect them. If market is strong during the ghost month, then it will. The impact will be very minimal. So in our case, the market does not look so good. So we might see a very boring market with a very low volume.
Okay.
And of course, with positive inflation print and other global events that we might be hearing for the next couple of months, we might see the market improving a little bit more.
All right. Thanks again, Harold Tan, for your market insights. Have a good day.
My pleasure speaking with you, Stan.